All right, praise the Lord. One problem after another. Currently, we're using my phone. Just all of a sudden, my phone decided to just change and switch cameras, and so I'm looking out at the sanctuary rather than looking back at me. Pray for us. We need to get a video camera this week. We need to put some things together. We've been working on that, and actually some have started giving toward an offering to help us get a video camera. We'll get to that. All right, let's get back to what I want to look at this evening, and that is, how do I get back to where I need to be? How do I begin to really see the blessings of God when I know I've messed up? And I, from visiting people sometimes and looking at people in counseling and talking with them, I hear this a lot. I've broken my life apart. I've messed up. I see all these things going on. And Pastor Tucker, how do I get back where I need to be? Well, in Micah chapter 7, verse 8, we see that. He begins to rejoice not against me, O mine enemy. When I fall, I shall arise. And it begins to really show us that by God's grace, if you've made a mistake, if your eyes have not been on Jesus, if you've had some kind of situation going on, all we need to do is get our mind focused back on God. I want to look at that this evening. From this wreck, I rise. Now, I know sometimes when people are going through the situation, it just seems like it's one problem after another, another bill, a car's acting up, or this situation, that situation. And somebody mentioned me one time, I feel like just giving up. I don't think I can keep on going this way. Every time I turn around, there is a problem. And I share with them, we know what we really need. Rather than just praying for the blessings of God, let's pray to have a relationship with God. We can get to God. God can work everything out. So I want to take a look at that this evening. From this wreck, I rise. Now, as we're going through the message, hopefully my phone won't act up again. But as we're worshiping God, I want you to think about this tonight. Are you where you need to be in God? Do you feel like every time you turn around, there's another problem, another challenge, another situation that you're having to go through? How many tonight, as you're listening to this message or thinking about God in your life, you know, this is the same thing someone said, every time I turn around, I'm having a problem. Now, one of the first things we've got to realize, and that is we have fallen, that we're not where we need to be. This is one of the first things, and I remember in seminary, and actually church years ago when I was in Germany, they were teaching us, before you get people found, you have to get them lost. You have to show them that just because you've got material wealth, because you've got nice cars and situation going on, money in the bank, a title, that does not mean that everything is right between you and God. And so we have to begin to really look at this. This is a community of people sometimes want to look at the wrong things. And when they have troubles or problems, a lot of times they want to make excuses for situations and blame it on everybody else. But really, the problem is we have a lack of God in our life. Somebody said, you know, if it wasn't for this situation or that situation, my life would be better. But the problem is there is a lack of God in our life. Now, let's look at this. One of the problems that Israel had, as seen from God's word, is that they were constantly experiencing situations, constantly going through some kind of problem, and they kept making decisions that made it harder and harder for them. Let's read Jeremiah 44, verse 17. But we will certainly do whatsoever thing will come forth out of our own mouth to burn incense unto the queen of heaven and to pour out drink offerings unto her, as we have done, and our fathers, our kings, our princes, and our cities, and in the streets of Jerusalem. For then had we plenty of victuals and were well and saw no evil. In Jeremiah 44, they said, we will certainly do whatever we want to do. We were going to continue to do what we want to do. And as they did that, it just made things worse and worse. They knew they were experiencing evil, but in their mind, it never dawned on them it's because of their bad relationship with God. They stopped having enough food, sickness began to come into them, and they couldn't understand what was going on. But the Bible speaks of another time also when people didn't understand what was going on. Let's look at that. Samson was having a problem. He was torn around with sin. He was spending time with a prostitute, and even at one point she got him to tell the secret source of his great strength and his relationship with God, being a Nazarite. She had been paid money to find out this secret. But the thing is, when she finally was able to cut off his hair and interrupt, he totally interrupted his walk with God, he didn't even realize that God had left. Now let's look at that. Judges 16:20. And she said, the Philistines be upon thee, Samson. And he woke out of his sleep and said, I will go out as other times before and shake myself. And he wist not that the Lord was departed from him. Okay, Can everybody hear that this evening? And he wist not that the Lord was departed from him. How many times have you said, I don't understand what's going on. I don't know why I'm having all these problems. I don't know why I'm having all these situations. And really, a lot of times, as we sit down and talk with people and we pray with them and we, you know, just kind of listen to what they're saying and what they got going on, it's not that God has been mean to them. It's not that God is trying to punish them or really, you know, purposely trying to do things against them. The fact is, they need to have a walk with God. They don't realize that they're not walking with God. Somebody may have a bumper sticker on the car. Some people wear a chain around the neck, a cross around their neck. Some people have, just kind of things that they say that they love God. But having a bumper sticker in your car, having a chain, a cross around your neck, is not the same as having Jesus in your heart. To know for a fact that you're walking with God and that God is in your heart. Now, there's another situation where people did not even know that they weren't right with God. It was the children of Israel were invading after Jericho. And they had come up against some people. It was a city called Ai. And as they began to go to that battle, they lost the battle. And they didn't even understand what was going on. And that's found in Judges chapter 7, verse 11. It says, Israel has sinned. And they also have transgressed my covenant, which I commanded them. For they have taken a cursing and have also stolen and disassembled also. And they put even among their own stuff. In each situation, with Samson, Joshua here, and the people of Israel, they didn't realize that they were walking blindly. They were walking around and not understanding the blessings of God was not upon them. And as they began to make one decision after another, their life just kept on getting worse and worse and worse until finally, hey, all of a sudden, what's going on? We don't understand. Why is nothing good happening? How many of you can relate to that? There's one thing after another, and we don't have understanding what's going on. And really, when you have to look at it, it's all based on how's everything between you and God. Now, oddly enough, when I have counseling time with people, that's one of the first things I ask. As they begin to tell me all these things that are going on in their life, and I say, how's everything between you and God? Oh, Pastor Tucker, that's not what I'm talking about. I'm not talking about my religion, God. I'm talking about my bills and my pain and my body and this situation, all this drama in my family. All this is going on. I said, wait a minute. How is everything between you and God? See, men sometimes don't realize that a lot of the situation is because of sin in the heart and mind. And so they will complain to me and they'll fuss. Other people have good marriages. Other people have good lives. Other people have cars. And other people have homes. And why can't I have it? When is it my turn? But like Samson and Joshua and the children of Israel, you have got to realize that sin in you is destroying you. You're in this wreck because of sin. Romans says, for scarcely for a righteous man will one die, yet peradventure for a good man some will even dare to die. But God, committing his love toward us, and that while we yet sinners, Christ died for you. When you don't have Jesus in your life, you're going to have problems. You've got to realize why things are the way they are, and that's because God is not found in your life. Now, once you realize that you've got this lack of God in your life, then you've got to go one step beyond that and begin to really put some things together. You see, because Samson walked right into the arms of the Philistines. Joshua walked right into the arms of the men of Ai who defeated them. And sometimes I know you feel like, man, every time I make a move, I'm making a mess out of something. Every time I try to do something, I am making a mess. You've got to get to the place that you realize enough is enough. Can somebody say amen to that this evening? Enough is enough. I'm tired of making bad decisions. I'm tired of feel like I'm going downhill and it's getting steeper and steeper. How do I get off this ride? From this wreck, I rise. You realize that you've fallen, okay? And you've come to that realization, you realize something's not right. You begin to ask yourself and look at all this. Now, I know sometimes it takes me a little while to deal with people because they keep saying, why me? Why is this going on with me? And they have a lot of emotions that they're trying to deal with as they try to figure this out. But you see, you have to really get down past the emotions to making something happen. I know sometimes if I had a little bit more money, I wouldn't be in the debt that I'm in. If I had a car, I'd be happier. If I had a nice home, oh, things would be so much better. But even if you had a nice home, money in the bank, you'd still have problems. Why? Because you still have sin on the inside. I can't stress enough how much important it is to have a solid walk with Christ. God is love. He is kindness. He's always there for us. And when you have God in your life, it's like God makes things happen for you. You have peace in the midst of the storms, all kinds of situations going on. But no matter what's going on in your life, he's right there holding your hand. How about you tonight? Can anybody relate to this? And as we're talking to people sometimes, this is what I'm hearing over and over again. How do I get my life back? How do I get to the place where things are not always going and bad for me? You see, failure is happening not around you. And please, I want you to hear what I'm saying here. And I'm not trying to put anybody down, not trying to throw anything, but I want to do some biblical teaching here tonight. Failure is not happening all around you as such. And that, you know, as far as why you're going through this, failure is happening inside of you. For sin, taken by the occasion of the commandment, deceived me, and by it slew me. In Romans 7:11. As long as we're walking around in sin, we're walking around in a problem. You can be this man, you can have this suit on, you can have that car, you can have all the stuff that you want, and when it's all said and done, none of that is going to help you like God can help you. Nobody can do for you what God can do for you. As you begin to just go through all your situations, you've got to come to realize that you are the problem. And I know when I say that, sometimes people say, oh, well, I'm not the problem. I couldn't possibly be the problem. But Romans 7:15 says, that which I do, I allow not. And what I would, that I do not. But what I hate, that do I. In other words, we've got something within us that's causing us to keep doing the wrong things. And we keep going down the wrong path, and we keep allowing things to come up to us. And as long as we're allowing those things to come up in us and continually direct our path, we're going the wrong way. You see, the reason you're in a mess right now, and I need somebody to understand, we're not throwing stones at you, but you're asking, how do I get my life back? You've got to understand where you're at right now. Right now, you're outside of the will of God. You're outside of God's care. God is calling you, come on in. God wants you, come on in. He wants to embrace you. He wants to love you. He wants to bless you. But you're on the outside. And as long as you're on the outside, you're not getting the blessing that you need. It's like, you know, in a candy store. You look on it from the outside in and say, oh, that candy is good. But you never experience that candy until you come on inside to the store and experience it for yourself. As long as you're on the outside of God and the outside of church, and you know, you may shout amen. You may go around telling everybody how much you love God. But the fact is, as long as sin is in your life, you're going the wrong way. And you've got to begin to realize, I'm walking around without God. And as you're allowing the devil to make decisions for you, you typically make bad decisions. Can somebody say amen here? Put it in the comments or think about it yourself. How many times have you just berated yourself? Man, why did I say that? Why did I do that? Why did I come up with that decision? And it's because those decisions that you made were not godly inspired. They were not made because you spent time in God in prayer. It wasn't because you allowed the Spirit of God to lead you. It was a carnal thought came to your mind, and you made a decision, and there you went. Come on now. I'm not, again, not talking bad about anybody, but you know it's the truth. As we begin to go through our life, we realize we have been making some bad decisions. Put in the comments if you can just be honest with yourself and say, I've made some bad decisions. I should have prayed about it. I should allow God to help me. You see, I read this years ago. It's about former President Ronald Reagan. He had an aunt who took him to a cobbler to get a pair of new shoes. And the cobbler asked young Reagan, do you want the square toes or do you want round toes? And unable to decide, Reagan didn't answer, so the cobbler said, well, just come back in a couple days. Several days later, the cobbler began to tell me he was ready, so he went to get his shoes, and the cobbler had made one shoe with a round toe and one shoe with a square toe. And he said, this will teach you to never let people make decisions for you. Ronald Reagan said, I learned right then and there, if you don't make your own decisions, somebody else will. And can we say that if we're not living for God and living for doing what God wants us to do, if we're not going to make a godly decision, the devil will help you make those wrong decisions. This is why so many people are going through so many problems. My life is a mess. My life is not where it ought to be, and I need to change. How do I change what I'm going through? I want a good life. Now, someone said, I want to be happy. I want blessings. I want everything. But before you get to that, you have to have God in your life. And many people will deny it. They'll deny saying, no, the devil's not directing me. The devil's not promoting me. I'm making my decisions. That just some things have happened. You see, but that's not true. Romans 6:16 says, know you not to whom you yield your service to obey. His servant you are to whom you obey, whether sin unto death or of obedience unto righteousness. You see, the thing we have to begin to realize is because we are in sin, we are letting the evil one lead you and direct you. John 8:44 says, you're of your father, the devil, and the lust of your father ye will do. He was a murderer from the beginning and abode not in the truth, because there is no truth in him. When he speaketh a lie, he speaketh of his own, for he is a liar and the father of it. You see, you are in this wreck right now because there's a lack of God.
Now, I need somebody to shout with me tonight. Again, we're not trying to throw stones at anybody, but this is not about making you feel bad. I want you to come back up out of that situation. I want you to be blessed. I want you to have the blessings of God in your heart and mind. And I realize continuing going down the road that you're going down is not going to change anything. You do the same thing over and over again, you have the same results. If you want new results, you got to do something different. And so what we have to do, we've got to get to God. Lord God, I pray right now, help me. God, I realize I've gone wrong. I realize I've done the wrong thing. Lord, I want you to begin to guide me and direct me. You see, from this wreck, I rise. God can pick you up. God can turn you around. God can put you on solid ground. He can do a work in your heart and mind. But you've got to first come to him. You see, you've got to realize why we failed. Now, your money's almost gone for some. Some can't find a work, come say, I can't find a job, or others. I mean, life sometimes is full of hard decisions. And one of the decisions that we have to make, and that is, I've got to let go and let God. I really have just got to get to a point where I'm, instead of trying to figure it out and worry about if I serve God, my girlfriend's going to get mad. If I serve God, boyfriend's going to get mad. If I serve God, family's going to get mad. You have to let, if they're going to get mad, let them get mad. But God will make you glad as you begin to put God first and just make up your mind, enough is enough. I've gone the wrong way. I'm tired of my situation. Now, there's some, they're going to always want to just stay in that situation and blame everybody else for what they're going through. They're in a wreck, they're in a situation, but rather than try and change that, they want to blame everybody else. And I know there's people like that, and I've talked to some like that, but I just happen to believe that somebody watching this video is ready for a change in their life. I just have to believe that somebody watching this video right now is ready for God's blessings to begin moving all through their life. You see, no matter what the need is in your life, my God is able. If you need peace, my God is able. If you need healing, my God is able. If you need strength, my God is able. All you've got to do is get to a place that you say enough is enough. And as you look at this, I have to turn myself to God. I've got to get back to where I need to be. Now, as we realize we're not right with God, whether we've never served God before or we were serving God for a period of time and we allowed our distraction of this life to get us off target, whatever the case may be, you begin to realize, okay, you know what? It's time to change. God changed my life. God helped me. Now, sometimes I ask people, what happened? You used to be excited about God. There was a time that if it was 7:30, you were one of the ones in the church. What happened? And a lot of times, it's because we got distracted. We allowed the enemy to distract us because of all the some things we were going through. And we stopped praying, and we stopped reading the Bible. Can anybody relate to this? Have you ever got so busy in your life, and it was just going down one situation, and next thing you know, you're way far away from God. Haven't read the Bible, haven't prayed in a while. I ask people sometimes, how's everything between you and God, and how's your Bible reading going? Oh, you know, Pastor, I'm sorry. I really have not been reading my Bible. I really haven't. Well, when do you pray? You know, when do you have your daily devotion or what time of day? You know, I really haven't been doing that lately. I haven't really been praying. There you go. Somewhere along the line, you've been focusing on the problem more than the problem solver. And the more you think about the problem, the more you've been going down the wrong road. You see, all the while, the devil's just laughing at you. He knows that the more you think about the problem and the more you're trying to put it together without God's help, the more of a mess you're going to make. And this is why we see in Micah chapter 7, rejoice not against me, O my enemy. When I fall, I shall arise. When I sit in darkness, the Lord shall be my light. From this wreck, from this all this I've caused, I acknowledge I've made some bad decisions. I should have prayed. I should have spent more time in God. I should have been in church. I should have been committed and dedicated to God, and I did not. I allowed my problems with my family, all my family drama. I allowed my pain in my body. I allowed all these things to change me. But Lord God, I'm ready to make my decision right now, God. I'm ready to get back to where I need to be. How about you tonight? Are you at that point where you can say, I am ready to get where I need to be? I don't want to sit here in this wreck anymore. I can't blame anybody else for what's happening right now. I know why I'm going through what I'm going through, and that is because I haven't spent that time in God. As we get ready to pray, when you have God in your life, he gives you strength. He gives us a peace that passes all understanding. And we have a strength to make it every single day. Now, I know some, and I hate to say this, but I have met some, they'd rather sit on the couch crying all the time saying, why me? Why am I going through this? Why is this? Why am I always broke? Why is my car always the worst one? And all these situations. But you can sit there and complain because of your situation, or you can do something about it. You can get to God. You can make up your mind, enough is enough. I'm ready to worship the Lord. Now, Samson, when he had made a mistake, and they actually put out his eyes, and they put him in the house and watch him just making fun of him, he prayed one more prayer. He said, Lord God, one more time, let me feel your strength. And he really began to give himself to God, so much so that God allowed him an opportunity to get back where he needed to be and have the strength. Somebody said that when he died, he killed more in his death than he did when he was living. Ahab was a very wicked man. But because he came to realize all that he had done also, he prayed, and God allowed him to die in peace. Can we say tonight that when you pray, God will hear your prayers? When you pray the prayer of repentance, I'm sorry, Lord God. I want to get to you. I want to stop all that I'm going through from this wreck. I want to get back up. I want to serve you, Lord God. And if you pray that prayer, God will hear you. He's very confident. Brother, God can help you to be confident and get you to the place that you need to be. You just have to make up your mind, I want to serve God. I know a lot of times we're stumbling around in our depression, stumbling around in our agony, stumbling around in our confusion, and next thing you know, we're saying things that we shouldn't be saying, or we've done things that we shouldn't be doing. How many times do you yourself, just made your situation worse? Just you got mad about something, and you just exploded all the stress in your life, and next thing you know, now you've made it even worse of a situation. It's time right now. Take a step back. From this wreck, I rise. Give your life to Jesus. It's not about, somebody said, my knothead husband. If he would just stop doing some things, I'd be much happier. It's my wife's fault. If she would stop doing certain things, my life would be so much better. If my kids were better, this was better, my job and all. Can we just stop right now and realize what the need is? We need a divine change within us. He said, if any man be in Christ, he is a new creature. You want to be blessed? You want to be happy? You want to have the thrill of God on the inside? Open up your heart to Christ right now. He said, behold, I stand at the door and knock. If any man hear my voice and open the door, I will come into him and will sup with him, and he with me. He's only a prayer away. He can help you get out of all of your problems. In fact, God can solve all your problems. You've just got to come to Jesus and begin to realize right now today that I have been in a wreck, I've been in a situation, I've been in a mess, and the problem is I put myself in that situation because of my distraction from serving God, because I want to do things my way. Okay, let's just call it out for what it is. Because of my rebellion and my disobedience, I'm in a certain situation. But I pray, God, get me out of this situation. Help me, God, to get where I need to be. I ask God, help me, pick me up. And you know what? As you pray that prayer right now, God will hear you. I'm getting ready to pray. Before I do, I want to share one thing with you. We call this man the prodigal son, according to the word of God's word. But he was in a situation also. And he had a religious epiphany. He began to realize, in my father's house, there's bread enough to spare. He said, you know what? Rather than sitting here and try to fight these hogs for these corn, I'm going to get up and I'm going to go to my father and I'm going to apologize. I'm going to tell him I'm not worthy to be your son and to take me back. But he made up his mind, enough is enough. I'm not going to fight with these pigs for their food. I'm going where I need to go and apologize. How about you right now? Are you in that situation? Enough is enough. I need strength. I need help. I'm going through all this, and I'm tired of crying about my situation. I'm tired of the confusion. I'm tired of the agony. I am tired of this mess. From this wreck, I rise. I know what I'm going to do. I'm going to get up, and I'm going to go. You're going to find out that God can truly bless you. He loves you tonight, and we appreciate all those that just make up their mind, hey, right now, I need Jesus. I mentioned this morning that this week I'm going to be trying to minister with people and counsel and help people out as much as I can because I've just had a lot of folks asking for prayer. So if you will, in the comments, or shoot me an email or a text message and let me know a good time for you and I to talk together, shoot me your name, number, and a time to call you. We'll have a quick time of prayer, and then if we need to, we can even schedule a longer time. But this week, I want to pray with you. How are you doing? Where are you at in Christ Jesus? And I want to do all I can to help you out. Again, in the comments, put down a good time to call you, your number, and we're going to just let God bless. This is the time for God to move, and he's moving, he's blessing others, and it's your time to get your blessing. From this wreck, I rise. God bless you. I'm Pastor Tucker, New Testament Christian Church. Come be with us on Bible study Tuesday night at 7:30. Come in and let's have a good time. Let's learn God's word. And we're going to talk more about this tonight's message. We're going to get into more little detail on Tuesday for Bible study. And then Thursday, we're going to have prayer meeting. Come pray with us and let's pray for our community, pray for this world. I just believe now is the time God is blessing. I'm Pastor Tucker. God bless you. That's our prayer.